Hey everyone, I've got a product review for you and I kind of need to set this up. So let me give you a definition, and the word we're going to define is ass. A hoofed mammal of the horse family with a braying call, typically smaller than a horse and with longer ears, in general use, a donkey. So for the sake of this video, that's the definition of ass. So without further ado, on with the big ass video. All right, as you can tell, I had a little bit of fun with the introduction to the video, but in all seriousness, I'm not new to this brand. I have seen their products around town. They actually have three of their big ass fans in an equestrian center that we have here in town, where they have rodeos and horse shows and such, and they're very attractively painted. It obviously has the logo on it, so once you see them, you don't forget them. And they do move a lot of air, especially when they've got blades that are, you know, the diameter of the swing on the fan is probably 18 to 20 feet. So it's like a helicopter being strapped up to the ceiling. So it's interesting, and they work beautifully. But this is the first time I've seen any of their light offerings, and they were kind enough to send me a couple of their garage lights for us to take a look at, kind of kick the tires on it, and see what they're about. So I'll bring you to the bench and we'll open this box and see what we've got to look at. All right, so let's open this up. I'm gonna try to stay out of the shot. It's a heavy box. And let's see, I'll just read what the label says. It says ceiling light fixture LED, 13,000 lumens, big ass garage light, 5,000K for Kelvin, 120 volts diffused LEN, 10 foot power cord with plug and S hook. So the part number is BAL-SHL1. And yeah, so let's open this up and see what we got here. Okay, so let me get it out of the, looks like we got some accessories in here. All right. It's got some heft to it. So, the back of this, can you see that? Let me bring you closer. Okay, and I'll do my best to try to keep this in the shot. So, all right, so here we go. So all of this is extruded aluminum. This is like one massive heat sink on the back of this. We've got two eyelets here. Got a real thick power cord. So this is a 10-foot power cord. Nice grommet there holding it. All your pertinent information on the back. Got the part number, serial number, all of that jazz. So let's look at the business end of this bad boy. All right. So I know that this also comes in a version that can have an occupancy sensor on it. And I assume that would go right there in the center. So these are your two LED strips. Again, this is all aluminum here. I mean, the whole thing, I swear the whole thing is one chunk of aluminum. It's got this nice cover panel here. And one of the things, let me switch sides here. One of the things that was in some of the material was that these are supposed to come out, I think, so you can clean them. So there's all the LEDs back there. Nice lens on that. So you can clean them if need be. Okay. So another thing that they sent me to go with this is a wall mount or a flexible mount kit because of my low ceiling. So what you could normally do with what's included in the pack is you have two screw eyes and you got two S hooks. So let me grab a tape measure, excuse me again. So let's see, what do we got here? So that's 16 on center, and so that means that you can find the studs in the walls or in the ceiling if it's on 16 on center. So that's a good number. Let's see, what else can we look at before we actually plug it up? Why don't we bust out the bracket and see what that looks like, and then we'll just see how bright this thing is. So let me grab that and I'll be right back. All right, so the bracket box is actually bigger than the light box. So let me open this up, see what we got. Some very bright and beefy pieces. This is all aluminum. Got some pieces floating around in the box here. Looks like they escaped from their plastic bag. All right, let me get that out of the way. All right, so we got a big bracket. This is a beautiful powder coat job. I mean, for it to be a bracket, that is some engineering and some attention to detail. Nice branding on both ends. And it looks like these are going to attach to the light. And then I would think that these allow you to pivot that. So why don't we just go ahead and put it together? So let me grab the light. And we'll go from there. There we have it. Now we have, and it rotates on the axis, which I find that kind of cool. So just so you can see what I was doing, basically just took these out, ran them back through the bracket and the housing again, and then added that nylock nut on the inside. So again, I do believe this whole piece is a one piece extruded aluminum, and yeah, that would account to the weight that it has. That's just tremendous. So let's light it up, see what she does. I know the video is not going to do it justice with the little LED light series that I've been working on, where I was showing the fixture that we cut on the CNC machine. Those pictures didn't do it justice, so we'll see how this fares. Let me get that out of the way. Holy mackerel, you do not want to look at that. So again, you're not going to be able to tell how bright this is, but that is bright. Okay, so I got one of the big ass lights mounted up here. Again, it mounts 16 on center. It's only, the whole thing including the bracket is 24 and a half inches, not including the knobs. The light itself is 23 inches and it's about, let's say 9.5-ish, a little bit less than 9.5 deep. So I just have the fluorescent lights on right now, and including the one behind the big ass light. So I'm going to unplug the one right there so you can kind of see the difference. And let's see the difference. So I don't know if that's doing that good of a justice to the light. I know that the camera has white balance on it, but that, it just at the table. Let me move this CNC top and let you see what that looks like under these lights. It is quite clear. So let me move you. So let me cut out all the lights except for the big ass light. So I'm not using my cheapo camera lights. I'm not using anything but the big ass light. That's the only light on in here. And it's so easy on the eyes. I mean, that's such a good color. Shining it back at you. It's actually messing up the camera. I love it. So that's one big ass light. And this is basically a hole. You know, I don't have white walls. This is the brightest wall that I have, and it's just a 4x4 piece of pegboard that's got gray primer on it. So everything down here is pretty much a light absorber. I've got OSB and dark surfaces. So, I mean, this is so much easier on the eyes than the yellow light that the fluorescents give off. So I don't even think I could try to do it justice in the camera. So you'll just have to take my word for it. That looks awesome. So just for comparison, let me go back. There's our Christie fluorescent lights. Let me plug the one up that's overhead. And let's unplug the big ass light. So back to yellow. So yeah, I think it's a huge difference. I know my eyes will appreciate it. All right, so there you have it. It's a good comparison between one big ass light and a lot of cruddy fluorescent lights. And I think there is a clear winner, and definitely a bright winner. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank Big Ass Lights for making this possible and sponsoring the video. You've got fantastic products in the lights, and I've seen the fans before, so I know those are great as well. So thank you again for making this possible. Be sure to check them out. The link's going to be down below, and I think if you buy them, you will be absolutely satisfied with them. So thanks for sticking around. Thanks for watching the video. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you next time.